Many people are uprooted from their consumption trot, feel abandoned by their beloved nanny state, and find security and protection again in the family lap. Others forcibly leave their hamster wheel of externally determined professional roles and seek new fulfillment in personal responsibility. People who lived side by side for decades suddenly care for each other. A wondrous time in attentive togetherness is suddenly possible again. Others speak openly of the virus of fear that is currently afflicting the world and of the impending great reset, or of the singularity at which computers will surpass human thought and take control. Some believe the final battle between good and evil has now come, and the last judgment is imminent. There are still signs and wonders in these difficult times. People are already looking through more and more and are getting into motion, are confronted with their fears and anxieties. They are pondering how it could come about that basic laws can simply be undermined by politicians, and that the elections are being falsified to an alarming extent. They are finally waking up from their slumber. For some, it will be a hard awakening because they still want to fight and maintain the old familiar order. The point now is not to fight the current lawless, chaotic conditions and their perpetrators, but to visualize and build the new society that we really want. Man has an undreamt of creative power if he takes personal responsibility and discards the old acquired victim role. Those who are constantly preoccupied with the old waste their energy and degrade their own vibration. There are already more than enough alternative media which fulfill this clarifying task. The real revelations will come later from appointed mouths of entities with much more insight. First, we should forgive the people who currently represent the evil ones, for they are the ones we will live with in the new society that follows. The transformative energies flowing in are so strong that they too will wake up and remember who they are, and that they are only playing roles voluntarily accepted. Hate will get us nowhere any more than fear. Good and evil roles alike are costumes of the one soul. When we fight these fellows, we dilute our own ancestral roles instead of taking care to maintain our higher frequency. This results from the fact that we already see through the game and know that the illusion of duality is no longer needed. Every fellow human being is a mirror for us, and there is something that we can recognize in each other when we live together. We, too, embody all kinds of roles in the multidimensional, simultaneous happening for the expansion of consciousness of all that is. Also those that disturb us in others, and that we therefore want to eliminate. However, we cannot do that at all. Everything is energy, and energy can never be destroyed. The old familiar moral concepts of good and evil, which we have tormented ourselves enough, have finally had their day. Souls live beyond such illusionary trained ideas. For many people, the topic of boundaries is very important. They have experienced painful transgressions of boundaries through carelessness and are now experiencing them again, for example, with the many so-called refugees. For the souls, this is not an issue. They live in unity consciousness. The souls do not need or cannot limit themselves. Only the personalities are affected, and they have the problem at times that they set themselves apart from those whom there is the least danger. Or they separate themselves so strongly that even the positive energy from outside no longer reaches their innermost being. If we intuitively shape our lives on our own responsibility, then we determine our living conditions in such a way that our environment fits us and our task exactly. By choosing the right environment, we determine our worlds of experience, alias timelines. It is good to consciously face the challenge of pushing boundaries more and more and to enjoy the freedom that results. It makes no sense at all to put this on the back burner. This applies to our own boundaries as well as to boundaries with which our fellow human beings believe they have to protect themselves. We do not have to support them in being able to maintain their conditionings. Decisive for our consciousness is now. First, to look into oneself and call up the events of all the lives available in each case, to remember them as they appear. Second, to face the respective topic and to look at it without evaluation, to let it have an effect on you. Third, accept what has happened and integrate it into the overall experience of the numerous simultaneous lives. No more repressing and rejecting. This is not an examination of conscience, but an unprejudiced self-reflection. It is no longer about repentance, penance, and so-called good resolutions for a supposed future. This view has only made us small and oppressible. No one has condemned us. We don't need to be saved. We do it all ourselves. And if there were once a kind of last judgment, then everyone would be his own judge. In the present theater of illusionary duality, it makes no sense to believe that the system could still be improved. As a planet of learning, experience and remembrance, our Earth is already functioning optimally. And let's not forget, we volunteered for this. We could have remained in an enlightened state on higher levels. The earthly illusion through which we have learned and understood a great deal, can only be dissolved by light and replaced by something completely different. The so-called evil does not have to be defeated for this, and computers will never replace intuition. After all, thinking does not take place in the head, but in the mental body. It makes no sense to concern oneself with what other personalities think or how they process their environment or information. There are people with very different personalities, and they are just as real and valuable as all the rest. Experiencing real, deep, painful, as well as joyful feelings. There is no one in our environment just to play a role as a soulless zombie. There are no people without a soul. We can firmly assume that everyone and everything is source energy. There is nothing outside of source, and that means that we are source too. Everything else exists only in our imagination, is illusion. This should encourage us to let all people create the reality they want to create and to live in it. Since all people are souls who want to have experiences, it would be highly unproductive and boring if all people had the same experience. And since there is basically only one soul, the exchange of experiences regulates itself as if by itself. In the earthly scenario, people who harmonize with each other already attract each other. You just have to let them. And that will finally happen now. Divide et impera is over. The exercise of power by deliberate separation is finished. We are allowed to choose our closest experience partners ourselves. And we can choose people who agree or disagree with us, depending on the meaning and purpose of the task. The souls bring us together. The crucial thing is that personalities no longer agitate and control each other, but lovingly respect and support each other. This is not only liberating, but it also helps to create our own so-called reality the way we want to experience it. That should be our main task now. Ramana Maharshi was once asked, "How should I behave towards others?" He answered, "There are no others." He meant to say, we are all souls of the one soul. We are all source energy. If we listen to the intelligence of the heart, the voice of the soul, the intuition, nothing can ever happen to us that harms. If we are loving to ourselves, we will be treated lovingly. The physical body is the soul's means of expression with which it experiences. The physical body is the final element, the end product of a multidimensional series of energy bodies of the soul. It is not a principle, that is, it has nothing to determine. The soul alone decides what it wants to experience. The state of the physical body has no compelling influence on the will and intuition of the soul. For example, it cannot be quasi-eliminated by unvaccination, because the connection of the building plan of the physical body, called etheric body, to the physical body is loosened, or because the connection to the soul begins to dissolve. With these speculations comes the idea that a genome-altering vaccination could prevent people from aspiring to higher spiritual goals or experiencing that they are essentially the soul. There is also speculation that the bad guys seek to prevent ascension. Within the framework of the old illusionary dualistic 3D system, they have indeed been able to successfully delay enlightenment all these millennia. But since the system has just been aborted, they have no chance at all. The hidden elites, who believed they could control world events in a certain direction, have failed and have already left the planet. Their posts were partly replaced by leaderless power people. Accordingly, chaotic the demolition of the old system develops. The power of the incoming source energies and from our friends from the higher realms overrides the negative effects of the harmful measures applied to humanity in these last days of the old system. And these incoming energies, some of which we feel painfully, because our physical bodies are not yet adapted to them, are in harmony with our souls, or the one soul. Stop your fight. Trust, and the truth will show itself.